Hey, what's up, guys? I'm sure everybody is aware that Windows 10 will reach its end of life in October 2025, which means that Microsoft will stop providing COT update for the operating system, and millions of people will be left without the computers that do not support Windows 11. Stay tuned. In this video, I will show you how to upgrade and install Windows 11 24H2 on unsupported hardware. My name is Mazhar, and at RightSolutions, I create tutorial for all you DIY people. If you're new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification for my next video. Now, without any further ado, let's get to this video. I got SS laptop K501U, and let me show you the configuration of this laptop. So let's go to the start button settings and then look for systems here. And now go down on the left side and click on abort. And this is my laptop's configuration. So you can see the processor, which is Intel process i7-6500U CPU. And I got Windows 10 Home. The last version was installed 22H2, and it was lastly updated in July 2021. And since then, I was trying to upgrade this, and it never got qualified for Windows 11. So now let's go and check the health of this PC and see if it is meeting the requirements of Windows 11. So just type in the search bar PC health check, and this dialog box comes up here. So just click on this check now button. It says let's check this PC if it meets the system requirements. So just click on this check now, and it brings up this results here, so which says this PC does not currently meet Windows 11 system requirements, and the processor isn't currently supported for Windows 11, and the processor is their process Intel Core i7-6500U CPU. So that's it. So I think let's close these dialog boxes here. We don't need it anymore. So close this one and this one too. And now let's close this about as well. Now open your browser and type in the search bar download Windows 11 and hit enter. And most probably you will see the first website comes from the Microsoft website. So just click on this download Windows 11. And now on this Microsoft website, you just scroll it down a little more. And here when you see this download Windows 11 disk image ISO, so click on this small arrow here and select the image Windows 11 multi edition ISO for the device 64 or 32, whatever is your device, and then click on download. It will load another page here, and this page will prompt you to select the product languages. And if you're upgrading, so just make sure that you select the same language which is already installed on your system. So in this case here, it's English United States. So I will go and select the same language here. So click on it and English US, yes, here. And then click on confirm. And it will bring up this download page for you. So you can see that download Windows 11 English, and this link is valid for 24 hours. So anyway, I'm just clicking it to download, and you can just see that my download has just started. It's about 5 gigs, a little more than 5 gigs of file. So it will take a little while. So it's completed already. We need to download one more file. So let's open up a new tab on this browser here. And in the search bar, type here, download Rufus, and hit enter. And this is the Rufus website here, first one. So just click on it. And then click on Rufus again. And this will load the Rufus page here. So on the right sidebar here, if you just look at these releases here, and it says Rufus 4.6, the latest version, which is actually released on October 21st. So just click on it, and this brings you to the download page here. Now it has a few versions here. So this is Rufus 4.6 EXE, which is an installation version. I'm not going to download this. I will just click this portable one. So just click on it. And it will start downloading, and it's a very small file. It's already downloaded. So let's open the download folder. My files are downloaded into the download folders. You can just find where your download file goes. So here you can see that I have Rufus 4.6, and then I have the Windows image. So right click on Rufus and select run as administrator, and it will prompt you to allow application to just look for the updates. So just say yes. So Rufus setup dialog box will come up. So this is the place where your USB should be showing. So this is the time to insert the USB flash drive here. So let me insert mine here, And you can see that this the Explorer is popping up. So just close this one here. And you can see that my USB had been popped up here in this box. So make sure that you are selecting the correct one. And in the boot selection line, just click on the select here and select the image we downloaded here. So you can see mine is in download folder. So click on Win11 ISO image. So click open. It will take a few seconds to scan the image. So just wait till it finishes scanning. So here it is done. So you don't need to change anything else. Just click on start. And this will bring up this dialog box. And you will have a list of options to choose it from. So the first one, which says remove requirement for 4GB RAM, secure boot and TMP. Two, and then the second one, remove requirement for an online Microsoft account. So I have selected these two. You can select more if you want, but I will select the last one, which says disable BitLocker automatic device encryption. And after you have made your choices, click OK. And this will bring up this warning for you that it will erase all the data from the USB you have inserted. So just say OK. And it will start preparing the partitions and you will see some pop-up windows are coming up. So just keep on closing it because it's creating some partitions. So you can just close this one and close this one as well. And I think we don't need this one too. And we can close this one as well. And maybe the browser also need to go. So here it's creating the ISO files, copying the ISO files to the USB. It will take a little while, depends on the speed of your PC as well. So I will just fast forward this. All right, so the process is completed. So now you can just close this dialog box. And now open the Windows Explorer and just click on My PC. And then this one, just click on this USB drive, which we just prepared. And here you will see setup.exe. So just double click on it. And it will prompt some permissions. So just allow these permissions. And it should bring up Windows installation process here. So just wait till some dialog box will come up here and you can just see that it says install Windows 11. So just click on next here and it will start checking for updates. Allow it to complete the process here. It could take a while, so just be patient and keep an eye that license agreement dialog box had just got minimized. So just click on it to bring it up. And of course, you need to accept the license agreements. And it will continue to look for updates here. It will take a little while to check for the updates. I will just fast forward this until this update is completed. All right, so updates are almost done here and it is presenting you with this dialog box here, which says what needs your attention. The following thing needs your attention to continue the installation and keep your Windows settings, personal files and apps. At the same time, it is also warning you this PC does not meet the minimum system requirements for the running Windows 11. These requirements help ensure more reliable and higher quality experience and so on. Yes, so we are well aware of it and just click on accept and it should start processing to install your Windows here. After collecting the information about your PC, it will present you with this dialog box here. You have the choice to just keep whatever you want to keep or you just want to completely install fresh Windows. When you're ready, click on install here and you can see that my Windows installation process had started. And if you had previously installed Windows, you know that it will possibly make your PC restart several times. And remember, I am recording screen on the same PC which I'm actually upgrading. So before first restart, my screen recording will stop. I will fast forward this installation process and see you after this installation completes on Windows 11. Here we are, my Windows installation just completed. I just signed in with the same old credentials. And now let's go and see the Windows version we just installed. So right click onto the start button, click on settings here. And now from here, just go and select system and just scroll it down, bring this about here, click on it. And here you can see that same processor, Intel i7-6500U CPU, and this Windows version is 24H2.
Thanks for watching, guys. If you think this video given you any help, please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you with next video. You have a wonderful day.